And now, as we stand together as one, together let us affirm our faith as we say, we believe
in God, love us, Maker and Sustainer of all life, of the sun and moon, of water and earth, of male and female. We believe in God, Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh, born of a woman's womb, servant of the poor. He was tortured and nailed to the tree. A man of sorrows, he died forsaken. He descended into the earth with the wings of hell. On the third day he rose from the tomb. He ascended into heaven to be everywhere present, and his kingdom will come on earth. We believe in God within us, the Holy Spirit and the cross of fire, life-giving breath of the Church, Spirit of healing and forgiveness, source of resurrection and of life everlasting. Amen.
And now standing, sitting, or kneeling as you are most comfortable, let us pray. You are above us, O God. You are beneath. You are in air. You are in earth. You are beside us. You are within. O God, you are in the betrayed and suffering people of our world, just as you were in the broken body of Jesus. We pray now for all that concerns us as we gather at this table together. O Christ, we bow before you in this shelter house of prayer once more to give thanks. Together we gather, celebrating your presence in creation around us, in the flowing air, and in the fertile earth. Christ, in your mercy. O Jesus, you sat at a table with the betrayed and rejected of Palestine. We pray for those today who do not feel welcomed in their daily lives. Christ, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O Jesus, you identified with the naked and with those who had no place to lay their heads. We pray for the thousands of homeless men and women, old and young, in our towns and in our cities. Christ, in your mercy. O Jesus, you belong to a refugee family. We pray for the millions of displaced people in our world and for the opening of borders to the nations. Christ, in your mercy. O Jesus, you cared for your companions and for the little ones who surrounded you. We pray for the dependent ones whom God has given us to care for. Christ, in your mercy.
Amen.
O Jesus, you who walk with the wounded along the road of our world's suffering, we seek your grace of healing for the broken people and places of our world. Especially today, remembering those who are on our hearts, and at this time, either silently or aloud, I invite you to name before God those who you wish to hold in prayer. Christ, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O Jesus, you prayed that we might be one as you and the Father are one. We pray that during this week we may feel at home with one another and with you in our midst. Let us offer our own prayers to God, both spoken and unspoken. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Teach us now, Christ, to pray as brothers and sisters as we pray together. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name.
Your kingdom come,
your will be done
on earth as in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread.
Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us.
Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Would you please stand? Brothers and sisters, may Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Let us greet one another with a sign of peace.
Thank you.
accept the praise and thanksgiving we offer you this day. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord.
Amen.
At the Last Supper, Jesus, sharing bread and wine, invited the disciples to share his journey. Like many grains of wheat becoming one loaf of bread, the disciples were invited to become one body with him. Here this day, through bread and wine, we renew our journey with Jesus and his disciples. Here, through bread and wine, we renew our unity with the earth and our interwovenness with the broken ones of the world. So come, taste of this bread and of this wine, gifts of the earth, work of human hands, food both of earth and of heaven. Among friends gathered round a table, Jesus took bread, and having blessed it, he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "This is my body which is given for you." In the same way, Jesus took wine, and having given thanks for it, he poured it out, and gave the cup to his disciples, saying, "This cup is the new relationship with God, sealed with my blood. Take this and share it. I shall drink wine with you next in the coming kingdom of God." So now, following Jesus' example, we take this bread and wine, the ordinary things of the world, through which God will bless us. And as Jesus offered thanks for the gifts of the earth, let us also celebrate God's goodness. Lord Jesus Christ, present with us now, as we do in this place what you did in an upstairs room, breathe your spirit upon us, and upon this bread and this wine, that they may be heaven's food and drink for us, renewing, sustaining, and making us whole, and that we may be your body on earth, loving and caring in the world. Brothers and sisters, look, the body of Christ is broken for the life of the world. Here is Christ coming to us in bread and wine, the gifts of God for you, the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus, have mercy.
Thank you. God, our Father, who gave to your Celtic saints the gifts of courage, faith, and cheerfulness, and set forth from Holy Isles to carry the word of your gospel to every creature, grant, we pray, a like spirit to your church, even at this present time. Further in all things the purpose of your community of St. James, that hidden things may be revealed to us and new ways found to touch the hearts of all. May we preserve with each other sincerity, sincere charity, and peace. And if it be your will, grant that this holy place of your abiding be continued still to be a sanctuary and a light. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now, my brothers and sisters, may the love of God fill you with joy and with peace. May the healing power of Christ strengthen and save you. May the Holy Spirit encourage you. May a thousand angels guide your steps. And may a blessing from this holy place protect you all of your days. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Our closing hymn today is The Lord of the Dance, and the words will appear on the screens. Feel free to sing along and clap if it so moves.
Thank you.
peace and friendship and hospitality, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit.